going on YouTube? Welcome back to the video. Welcome back to my channel. And today's video, you're going to be doing like a little vlog. But right now, I'm about to go to the gym with Ashley. 12 o'clock right now, so just gonna get it done out of the way. Usually we go later on in the nighttime, like 10 or 11. But yeah, we're gonna do it today at 12. Get it done. Today's chest and triceps, and then tomorrow I'm off. And yeah, I'm just gonna kill it. I'll show you guys what I'm working. So hope you guys enjoy the video. Alright guys, what's going on? Alex Brenna here, coming at you guys with a commentary. Today was chest and triceps. Hopefully you guys can hear me. But to start off this workout, we did a warm-up. And then right here, you're seeing me doing a leading up to my working set. So this bar is 55 pounds, guys. So right here, it was about like 200 pounds, I believe. Yeah, like 200 pounds right here. And then this set right here, because the bar is 55 pounds, different than usual, this is actually 225 right here. So we did 5 sets of 3 to 6 reps on the working set. So I led up to it, and then once I got to where I could do 3 to 6 reps, I did that for 5 sets. Right here, we're doing incline dumbbells. I always do incline on chest day, always. I just always do it. I've noticed a lot of gains from it. Right here, you want to grab dumbbells. I've noticed a lot of people who do incline dumbbells, they're way too scared to go higher in weight. Guys, you're not going to be stronger and get more muscle if you just stay at the same type of weight. You need to always try to move up, guys. Always. Once you move up, you're gonna get stronger. Once you get stronger, the muscle is going to come right after it. Those two go hand by hand, guys, together. They go Oreo and milk. So you need to be going heavier in weight. Doing 6 to 8 reps, and right here, doing a different exercise for chest. You guys probably have never seen this, but it's gonna work out your middle chest, so your inner chest. So what I did was I grabbed like a semi-heavy dumbbell. So all I was doing was a 45. Grab onto it firm, and then rep it out. We did that for 15 reps. Then we supersetted it with this right here that you guys are watching right here. We did that. Since after I did the other workout, it kind of burnt me out, so I was doing 8 to 10 reps on that exercise, and we did 3 sets of those. So superset it right after with that one, and then 3 sets. 15 reps for the first one, and then 8 to 10 reps. Right here, we're going on to chest flies. When it comes to chest flies, guys, a little tip. You guys can do any kind of chest flies you guys want. Just make sure you guys are feeling it, not that you're just doing it like you're just kind of like just throwing your hands together. You need to make sure that you're feeling it in your inner chest. Right after that, we supersetted it with the chest fly machine. I find it, I get a lot more contraction, and I feel the muscle fibers more when I'm standing up and my feet are in place on the seat to where I can't like move. You know what I'm saying? And then we busted out 10 reps right after that. This was killing me, so we're doing 2 chest flies. Again, guys, that was a superset. So right after, you want to do that exercise, right after, just do the chest flies, the cable chest flies, and then boom, superset it with the standing chest fly machine. Right here, moving on to triceps. This is our only tricep movement of the day, just because I do triceps a lot during the week. Arm days every day, basically. When I feel like stimulating them, when it's not arm day or back and biceps or chest and triceps, I just do them. You see me doing, this is basically a dip machine, but I went to my weight. So once you go to your weight, so let's say if you weigh 170 pounds, you need to put the weight at 170 pounds. And then right after the 170 pounds, I did a drop set to 160, 150, and then etc. So just 3 drops. And then we did that for 3 sets. Right after that, we burnt out on the next exercise. It's like an incline chest machine. If I go higher with the seat, it'll probably work a little bit of the decline. But a lot of gyms have this machine, so we just burn out with this. I did like 15 or 20 reps. burn out with it, two sets, and that was basically the workout for the chest and triceps. Guys, right after this video, we're going to do like a little vlog, and it's going to be basically just going on a yacht with my family because of my sister's birthday. And it was really fun, so I hope you guys enjoy the footage and just what it looks like, and then just enjoy the Clearwater Beach looks, I guess. But guys, as always, you guys can always look on my website, alexaprenant.myshopify.com. I have a fat loss program there, the same fat loss program that I'm doing right now. And just check it out. Link will be in the description box. Love you guys. Enjoy the rest of the video.
Just finished that workout, and I dropped the camera. And now there's a chip on the new camera. Right, babe?
All right, guys, this is my meal after the gym. Two servings of lean ground beef, 200 grams of egg whites, three turkey bacons, and two servings of hash browns. This is gonna hold me off for dinner because we're going on a boat and having dinner. And then I'm watching some Star Wars because I haven't seen that yet. Rogue One, haven't seen it, so yeah. The plan for today is we're going on a boat because today's my sister's birthday. We're going on a boat with my family and just having dinner on a boat. So it's gonna be like a 3-hour boat ride, and it's gonna be fun. I'll make sure that I'll get some footage and show you guys what I'm eating. But yeah, I'm gonna watch this, eat this, because it looks so damn good. In the truck with the fam.
Oh my gosh.
About to go eat dinner.
I wanna tell you a story. So I jumped over the little fence where my mom has flowers.
Yeah.
And I busted ass.
Wake up, kids, we've got a dreamer's disease. Age 14, we got you down on your knees. So polite, you're busy still saying please.
Currently waiting on my sister, but that is no surprise. So,
oh, I look like a freaking.
We're supposed to leave in like what, 20 minutes, and she isn't even here. So, she still has to park. This is an update. Just got home. I brushed my teeth and all that stuff, and I'm getting ready for bed. But it is 1 o'clock and you know, I had a really good time. It was my sister's birthday. You know, I love her to death. You know, I'm so happy that she enjoyed her time. I had a wonderful time with my family, man. Just wonderful. Like, if you actually take time and, like, appreciate the things that you're doing, you just, like, sit back and actually be like, damn, what would I be if I wasn't here with my family on a boat, eating dinner, a nice boat, and just watching the sunset on Clearwater Beach in Florida? You know, and if you don't appreciate that, then you're not going to appreciate anything in life. And, you know, small things like that, you know, it's so, like, it just really, like, makes me, like, just feel so good about myself and, like, what happened. And I always thank God for that stuff, you know, always thank God for the good and the bad. But, you know, I'm not going to, or your higher power, whoever your higher power is, but, you know, thank them because, you know, it's just really, it's really cool. And yeah, so I had a really good time. But you know, the only thing that I've been strict on my diet, guys, for like a long time. And the only bad thing that I had two meals. The first meal was what you guys saw, and then the second meal was the second meal that you guys saw with the steak. And and I had mashed potatoes, like half a serving of mashed potatoes, and then asparagus. And you know, I'm not gonna lie to you guys. So those are the only two meals that I had, which bumped me up to about 200 grams of protein, 180, 190, and I'm fine with that. But I had a piece of cake, two pieces of cake. No, I had a big piece. You know, I got cut a big piece. And so I'm gonna put that in as two pieces of cake. And then I had some bread. And you know, when you're going out with family and all that stuff, like I didn't even have to tell you guys that. I'm just telling you guys this because you guys might benefit off of this. And but you know, I'm not gonna sit here and pout and just get so mad that I kind of like messed up on my diet. It's not really a mess up because, guys, you know, if you're having like a family function and all that stuff, you know, don't just cut all that stuff out. You know, I only had one meal during the day because I knew like that I was going to dinner with my family, and I didn't know what to expect, you know. So, you know, I probably had like 300 grams of extra carbs, which means in 2 days I can't have the, you know, my refeed basically, because I'm on 130 grams of carbs every day now, and carb cycling. But you know, it just goes to show you that. Anyways, so I didn't even have to tell you guys that, you would never knew, but I'm just being straightforward with you guys because I love you guys. And you know, when it comes to family functions, don't just like completely like fuck them over and just don't go and all that stuff because you know you're on a diet, you know what I'm saying? Like, just, I could have not had the cake, but you know, my whole family was doing it. I got caught up in the moment and I was enjoying the moment. Now, will I have to do a lot of fucking cardio tomorrow? Yeah, I'm gonna be doing a lot of cardio tomorrow. I'm not gonna be like 45 minutes on the Stairmaster. And you know, I didn't completely ruin my diet, but you know, you just get back on the train and you just keep going and keep grinding. You know, it's what you do every single day that matters, not the one time you do something. And I haven't had fucking cake and bread in like so long. So you know, I'm just telling you guys this because maybe you guys can learn off of that. Don't freak out. You know, inside you might feel shitty because you know you cheat on your diet, but it's really not cheating on your diet. It's enjoying the moment with your family. You know, it's different than if you're going out drinking with your friends and all that stuff. And you know what I'm saying? It's different, you know. But if you're enjoying the moment with your family and it's like a family get together, like gathering, like fucking special occasion, like I get it. So just get back on the train tomorrow, like just like I am. Get back on the train, you know, grind again, and you know, just what you do every single day, not what you do every other fucking month, basically. And yeah, I'm just ending it with that. So I love you guys. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and stay tuned for the next video.
comment down any kind of like questions or whatever. Just y'all know where to.